This is part three of customizing a highway shield to label interstate highways. In the previous video, we downloaded Esri's transportation style and added it to our project. So let's go back to view the items on that. So we'll go to view, catalog view, and then click on the transportation style, and you can see the list of items. So what we're going to do is choose one of these items and then customize it and then have it accessible for future projects. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to add it to our favorites. So the first thing to do is to sort the items by clicking on name here. And the reason I'm going to have you do that is because the item we're looking for is called blank standard. So it starts with a B and it's easy to find if the list is sorted alphabetically. So right click on the item here and then click add to favorites. Now if we switch over to our favorites, we'll see that that item is present. So let's click on this. Now we have the pane that appears over here with a description of the items where we can change the name if we want. We can add it to a category. For now, we'll just ignore those and go to properties. Here we can see that the color of the shield is black and here's the size of it. What I want to do is have a black outline but a white fill. And I cannot control that here, but I can do so in layers. You can see now that I have the ability to change the color, which I will make white. And then outline color is here, which is 0 points. So I'll just make that one. You can see it in the preview window here. I'll click apply. And now it shows up in the favorites with the properties that I've just specified. Now you could make this any combination of color and outline and thickness that you want, and it will save. So how do we get this back in our map to replace this symbol? Well, in order to do that, we need to go to the labels of the interstate highways, and I'll click on the text symbol pop out, and that opens up the pane for the labels. Now, we only have the one label class in this layer right now. So in order to adjust the symbol, we have to do a couple of things, and that is to be aware of two things. First of all, the appearance on a highway shield will control only the number. If so, right now it's Tahoma, it's 7 points, it's regular and so forth. If I change that, only the number changes. So how do I change the shield? In order to do that, I need to go to the callout section. And I'll expand that, and you can see here's the symbol that's being used for the callout. So what I'll do is I'll click this drop down and then I'll go to more point symbols. And you can see now that the shield that I just edited and placed in my favorites is here. So I can say blank standard and say okay. And now you can see that the shield is here. Now it looks like we don't have a number because the number was white, so I need to change the color of my number to black. And now if I click apply, you can see that we have the interstate highway shield with a black number, and that will work well in a grayscale map. So that's how we can create a new shield that can be used in the future for our projects.